Alright, what's going on everyone? It's Piki Choco, and in today's video, we're gonna be talking about some interesting new news. So Columbine or Columbine, whatever you may call her. So a new information about her, rather a close one linking her with a very important Fatui and a playable one, and her possible release into the game. Heizu and Baizu crumbs that may give us an idea about the skills, and a Hopium 2.7 early livestream calculation based on some crumbs and news. So tons of interesting stuff, but before we get into that, just wanna ask that if you want to enter the two blessings giveaway, do check out the topmost link in the description and make sure to subscribe so that you won't miss on any latest news and stuff related to Genshin like this. Alright, now let's deep dive into the video right now and boom. So firstly, we'll take a look at short bit of Yalan update. So as per the latest speculations, the several rumors and reports of 2.7 getting delayed may have been reverted based on some recent changes. So about all those details and the 2.7 livestream date, we'll talk in the further part. So as for now, it seems Hoyoverse may be back on track with the schedule of 2.7. And given that the latest Apple theory or the energy gauze theory, there were many doubts raised about the compatibility of Yalan with other party units. So as of now, this specific aspect may have been worked upon. As a theory crafter, despite the uncle's claims, do predict that Yalan may be one of the best friendly in-slot characters. So it will be worth watching as to how Yalan revolutionizes the bow mechanism and brings any changes to it. Now moving on to Columbine. Upon hopping onto various forums, manga, webtoons, found out an interesting info. So Columbine may be an upcoming character who's a member of the 11 Fatui Harbingers and its archetypes. Now about her reference, here's what is shocking to me. So she's referred as the love of Piero and at the same time mistress of Arlecchino. Oh my gosh, this is some kind of a twisted love triangle, at least what I thought in the very beginning. But if we closely deep dive into the Fatui lineups and the strategy to properly balance the power and at the same time keep them under control of the one and only Tsaritsa, so latest speculations also have pondered on this particular theory that it may have been Tsaritsa who's advised Columbine to break the heart of Piero and go on with Harlequin, because consider the power and position that Piero holds, it may be difficult for Tsaritsa to control him if a situation of imbalance of power arrives. So in short, keep Piero under control so that he doesn't go out of hand of Tsaritsa, and also keep Harlequin under control so that he helps expand the squad of Fatuis, which may help them in purpose of gaining the visions from the Archons. So actually kind of a shocking take, but kind of even making sense at the same time if we refer all of the Fatui Harbingers and their lineups, because no matter how powerful and disciplined the Fatui like Pulcinella, Sandrone, Dottore, Piero, Scaramouche, or any more maybe, having a major political representation as well as powerful delusions, if by any chance even one of them goes rogue, it may be a big problem for Tsaritsa. As for the power and position of Columbine, it is only said that she may be quite a bit powerful than Signora, and as for the position, she may be somewhat a near bit of Scaramouche, and given her references belonging to Sumeru, it will be very interesting to watch if they show her along with Harlequin in Chasm or Sumeru, and do they reveal some bit of Piero. So very excited for that. Now moving on to Heizu. So as we all know, the character interactions and their involvement in stories and quests are a major hint for them becoming playable, as we can see in the case of Kuki, Yaimiko, Ayato. So similar is being said the case of Heizu the detective. So recent speculations about his element and rarity have popped out. So one of them being of uncles who speculate him based on the importance of him in the storyline being a 4-star animo character based on some news and some patterns, while the others speculate about him being a 5-star electro user on the basis that he belongs to Inazuma. And since detective class hasn't been shown that much, it may be a great opportunity for them to showcase him as a 5-star. Personally, I'll go with the uncle's opinion because it makes some kind of sense, as by any chance if they plan him to release before Sumeru, it's highly likely based on the marketing strategy that he may be a 5-star. So kind of excited to see him as well. Now moving on to the most important 2.7 live stream and some real-time news associated with it. Now the very first speculation coming forward does state that the delay that was planned for 2.7 earlier may not happen, as Honkai Impact, one of the games sharing similar universe with Genshin, its live stream was held recently in its official time period with a zero delay and time. And secondly, the battle pass change that was planned for the delay is speculated to be reverted again. So these two factors are pretty much the strong indicators that 2.7 won't be delayed, and the reruns that may have been planned earlier like Kazuha, Zhao, or Klee may have been again moved to 2.8. In my opinion, HoYoverse pretty much knows that delaying version 2.7 despite many more difficulties won't be good, as the game is already running in a dry state. Although there are some good events that really test out players' capabilities, yet new characters and content is the very much thing that the player base is expecting, especially when Sumeru will come in 2 to 3 months. And I've also heard a recent speculation that in order to fill up with all the rumors and frustration of the players regarding the 2.7 delay, HoYoverse may showcase either Baizu or Saino as a character in the live stream that we've all seen in the usual end screen phase. So kind of excited if they really show a little bit crumb of Sumeru. So personally, I'm very hyped and excited for 2.7. So that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed the video. So make sure to subscribe to not miss on any latest news like this. As always, I'll see you all in the next video with some interesting new news. Until then, stay safe and stay picky.